got the bag. Tell a friend, she got some ass, bring it in. It's on the news, CNN. Yeah, will it in? I got the bag. Tell a friend, she got some ass, bring it in. It's on the news, CNN. Yeah, tripping. When I got the TikTok missing.
Hello, you guys. This is my hair wash routine, my new and improved hair wash routine from start to finish. So to start out, I am going to be pre-pooing my hair, which if you don't know what that means, it just basically means you are preparing your hair to be shampooed. So anywho, I am going to take a water bottle and lightly spritz my hair because my hair is a hot mess. As you can see, it's dirty, it's matted, and needs to be washed. And then I am going to lightly detangle my hair. And after I lightly detangle my hair, I am going to take some aloe vera gel. And I mix it in with some extra virgin olive oil. And I'm going to apply that to my hair. If you want to see how I make my aloe vera gel pre-poo thingamajig, just let me know in the comments below. And I'll have that out for y'all. So that is the consistency of the pre-poo. It's slimy and gross, but it really helps my hair stay moisturized throughout this whole entire process. And it also has been helping my hair grow, as you can see. So I apply that all over my head, and then I divide my hair up into four sections, twist the sections up, and I let this pre-poo sit on my head for like 15 to 20 minutes. So yes, I still do wash my hair in sections. If you are an OG subscriber, you know that I used to do that. I still do it because it really helps keep my hair from tangling up real bad. And girl, I just use a plastic shopping bag for my cat. So now this is my shampooing routine. I love this shampoo from OGX. It is great for people who have dandruff like me because it has tea tree in it, and tea tree is really great for helping soothe and heal and balance the scalp. So as you can see, I actually shampoo my hair with my hair still in twists, which is a new thing that I started doing. I do that to really focus on my scalp because that's really what I want the shampoo to focus on, is my scalp. And then after I am done scrubbing and massaging the shampoo into my scalp, I wash it out while it's still in twist. And it still cleanses the rest of my hair because the shampoo, you know, runs down the rest of the shaft of my hair. And eventually I do untwist the sections just to make sure that I got all the shampoo out. Then I shampoo my hair again using that Argan oil moisturizing shampoo just for safe measures. So for my protein treatment, I do use the rice water method, and I'm making that face because if you know anything, fermented rice water is just, it just does not smell good. It smells disgusting. So yeah, that's why I'm making that face. But I am spritzing that all over my hair, and then I'm going to place a plastic bag on my head and let that sit for like 15 to 20 minutes. Then after I rinse the rice water out, I am going to condition my hair, and I am using my Beat Up Aussie 3-minute conditioner. I love that conditioner because it has great slip, so it helps so much with detangling. So I apply that to my hair in their sections, and then I finger detangle, and then when I'm done with the section, I twist it back up. And as you can see, I use the praying hand method whenever I apply conditioner or any product there is, because that really helps coat the hair with the product. And then after I'm done detangling each section, I rinse it out with some warm water. Now for my deep conditioner, I'm going to be using this heat activated mask from African Pride. Love this mask. I just started using it. I love it. It's great. Highly suggested for people who have type 4 hair. But anywho, I apply that to my hair. And at this point, I don't have 4 sections. I just have 2 sections because I'm ready to get this over and done with. So I apply the deep conditioner to both sections, and then I twist my hair back up, and then I put a plastic cap, and I let my deep conditioner sit for a minute, honey. Like, I let it sit for at least 45 minutes. Sometimes I let it sit for like 4 hours, so it just really depends on my mood. But anyhow, yeah, I rinse out my deep conditioner with warm water. And that is pretty much my hair washing routine. So after I'm done washing my hair, I do seal in the moisture using some coconut oil. So I take some coconut oil and apply that all throughout my hair. And then I take this leave-in conditioner from Kinky-Curly. Is that what they call it? Kinky-Curly. I use that leave-in conditioner. I love it. It's so expensive, but I love it. It's just so great. It keeps my hair so moisturized. And then after I do that, this is great for people who have dandruff. So I take tea tree oil and I take sulfur 8. I apply both to my scalp and massage it in. And when I tell y'all, baby, that is the holy grail for me when it comes to my dandruff. Like, it helps with my dandruff so much. So after I do that, then I style my hair as I would. And that is my hair wash routine. I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'll see you all in the next video. Bye.